Okay. Welcome aboard the Morning Mayhem, now Afternoon Mayhem radio show. I don't know why I call my show Morning Mayhem. Joe, you look tired. Wake up.
I am tired.
Why are you tired?
I just didn't get enough sleep.
Oh, we never get enough sleep. No. We're college students, right?
Yeah.
So we have a special guest in the studio today, Joe. Would you like to introduce them, or yeah, do you want me to do it?
Yeah, you do it.
Actually. Okay. The Leukemia and Lymphoma Society.
Of Northern Ohio.
I knew there was a name attached to the end of it. I didn't know what the name was. Can you close the door, please?
Yeah.
Thank you. Or Mike can close it. Thank you, Mike. So, Caitlin and Aaron are joining us from the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society of Northern Ohio. Mm-hmm. So, first things first, I just want to talk to you guys about how you guys got started in the organization yourselves. So, how long you've been there and what you guys do, exactly.
Yeah, so, this is Caitlin, and I have worked there for a little over 2 years. I was originally in the film industry working in Atlanta, and I wanted to move home and do something more rewarding. So, applied for a part-time position at LLS. Got the job, and then since there, I've moved up, and so now I work on our Man and Woman of the Year campaign and our regatta in the summer.
Cool.
And then I just graduated from college myself, so I graduated from Kent State University in May. Didn't know exactly where I wanted to go with my career, so I did some freelance contract work with News 5 in Cleveland, doing digital content as a journalist, and just decided that I wanted to go into something a little more stable, you know, where I knew what my hours and my life was going to be like every day. So I came to the nonprofit world and joined LLS about 6 months ago. This week is my six-month anniversary. Yeah, big deal. Right around Valentine's Day coming up.
Oh, right on Valentine's Day, too. That's even better.
What were you doing in the film industry in Atlanta?
So I was working as a production assistant on some different films.
What films?
I worked a little bit on The Hunger Games and Insurgent.
You did Hunger Games.
Oh, cool.
Cool.
Just one of them, yeah.
Which one? I got to ask.
Mockingjay Part 1.
Oh, Mockingjay, okay.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it.
It was a lot of fun, but this job is much more rewarding.
Definitely. So enough about our former film careers and everything else. I could talk about my film, but no one wants to see that because you'll burn your eyes and all that fun stuff. So, tell us a little bit about the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. What the goals are of the organization? Is it to just completely get rid of leukemia? Is it to find a cure? Is it what is the?
Yeah. So the mission of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society is to find cures for all blood cancers. So leukemia, lymphoma, myeloma, to ensure access to the most appropriate treatments for blood cancer patients. So we are in it for three reasons: patient access, advocacy, and research.
Okay.
But we do joke a lot in the office that our goal is really to put ourselves out of a job. Like, we want to be able to put a clothes sign on our office doors that we're no longer fighting these cancers. They just don't exist anymore. Mm-hmm. So that is kind of the end goal, to make sure these big words don't exist.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
Fine.
So one of the things I've never understood is what leukemia and lymphoma really are. We say they're blood cancer, but that means nothing to me. Like, what exactly is leukemia and lymphoma? What does it do?
So it's funny. So I work in school, so I explain this to kids all the time. It's actually one of my primary roles. So the simplest way I can put it is that you have red blood cells and white blood cells in your body. Red blood cells carry oxygen. White blood cells fight off infection and germs. When, say, you need like 50 white blood cells to fight off the flu, all of a sudden your body has 500 white blood cells and your body doesn't know what to do with the excess. So it's really all based on white blood cell count. So that's kind of the first indicator, whether those show up in the form of a tumor because they've all banded together, whether it just shows up in a routine blood test because you felt more tired, you felt really lethargic. It can present in a lot of different ways, but at the end of almost any diagnosis, it all comes down to white blood cell count and how fast your white blood cells are multiplying, since your body only needs so many of them. And leukemia and lymphoma are two types: Hodgkin's, myeloma, everything else. But there's 129 different strains of blood cancers too, so lots of different ways that can present in your body.
129 different. Joe, you said you had written some questions for them. Do you want to read off something for you?
Just the questions that were on here.
That's okay. Read off anything you want.
All right.
He's going to ask you a question from our sheet that we had prepared ahead of time.
All right. Bring it on.
What is the size of your organization?
So we are, our chapter in Northern Ohio has 17 employees, three that are in Toledo. And then the whole organization has 56 chapters across the country. Mm. We have a couple chapters in Canada, and we're headquartered in Rybrook, New York.
Wow. Rybrook? Is that near NYC, or is that
It's
Albany?
It's like a 45-minute train ride outside of mid-Manhattan.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yep.
Got something else over there, Joe?
How is your impact measured through...
we measure in a variety of ways. We get these really cool reports at the end of each year. So, like, last year, we have a count that 698 families in the Northern Ohio area, so that's anywhere from Toledo to Mansfield, benefited from our copay assistance. That was $1.6 million dedicated to that. We had a certain amount of families that received over $19,000 in funding for travel. So we really look at kind of things that tie into our research, advocacy, patient access, and really narrow it down. We can pinpoint how many families in Cleveland, Akron, Toledo, Kirtland area, you know, Willoughby benefited from civic programs. And those are the numbers that we always look at the year end and the numbers that drive us as we're fundraising and building money.
So let's talk about fundraising a little bit. You bring up fundraising. Tell us a little bit about how you guys fundraise. Do you guys have any special events that you guys do? Do you guys just look for donors, big and small? I mean, what do we do with for fundraising?
So we do several different things. You brought up donor. We have a great donor development person at our office. So she just goes and invites different people who are normal donors to give more money to the organization through what we do for our local impact. And then as a chapter, we have different events throughout. So I work on our Man and Woman of the Year, like I said, which is a fundraising competition for businessmen and women and then college students. So we started the college portion 2 years ago. This is our second year. Last year, four college students raised over $74,000. Nice. So that was crazy. Crazy awesome. So we're looking, we have six girls now signed up, and they're going to do a great job. We have our Students of the Year, which is a very similar program, but students fundraising to win a scholarship, so high school students. We have Team and Training, which are different running, biking, different programs like that. Our Regatta, which is our summer sailing program. Mm-hmm. And then we have our Light the Night Walk that is in the fall. That's your basic walk, but it's very cool because it's at night, and so we have different colored lanterns. And then Aaron can speak a little about our student series.
Okay.
Yeah, so my job is we have the collegiate and high schoolers fundraising, but I work with kids grades K through 12, so kids as young as 5 years old and kids ready to go off to college, working in schools to help schools raise money. So right now we have 525 schools across Northern Ohio who are who either finish a program currently running it or going to run it in the spring. Those schools raise on average about $1,500 a pop, but we also have schools that have goals like $25,000.
Oh,
so
wow.
Those are kids coming together who, yeah, learn a very basic level of like what blood cancers are, how we can help kids, and do really fun, creative things in schools, anything from Spirit Weeks to Coin Wars. And we are projected to raise like over $500,000 in schools alone in the Northern Ohio area from that.
So how, I don't know if you guys would know the answer to this. I know I don't know the answer. How, and I don't know if I want to ask this question, but I feel like I need to. How much does it take to fight something like lymphoma or leukemia or something like that? Do I want to ask that question?
I always use, so for every patient, different. I always use my grandfather, who was diagnosed at age 93, and I always use him as kind of my token example because I saw his medical bills. He was getting injections for his form of treatment bi-weekly, so every other week he had to go in for shots, and one shot cost $7,000. So he, just because of his age, opted out after two rounds, but I mean, that was $14,000, and those two rounds didn't immediately, you know, cure him. So we have patients whose medical bills are genuinely over $1 million if they've been fighting for over a year. I know my campaign manager was diagnosed at age 17, and she said she's coming up on her 10-year like survivorship celebration, and in 10 years she said her medical bills from diagnosed day to today have surpassed $1 million as well. So it's an expensive battle to be fighting, for sure.
Yes.
But, sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, like Aaron said, anyone can fight from a couple weeks, if they're lucky, to a couple years. Mm-hmm. It just depends on the person and what blood cancer they're fighting.
Right. So we talk about the organization as a whole. How, if somebody wants to volunteer for you guys, whether it's through sending Facebook messages, gathering donors for you, going to different events, saying, hey, I represent the LLS, and people ask you, how do they get involved with that?
So people can get involved in a number of ways. We have several lovely ladies that come to our office bi-weekly and help us with different office tasks. And then on the flip side of that, we have people that come and help us do some manual labor at like our Light the Night Walk, for an example. Okay. So people can get involved in any of our campaigns that I mentioned before. We always need volunteers. So whether they want to do something in the summer regatta, or whether they want to do something in the fall at our walk, all they need to do is visit our website, www.lls.org/NOH, and there is a link where you can volunteer. It will lead you to my lovely coworker Brittany, who will help you find the perfect event you can volunteer at.
LLS. I can type really well sometimes. LLS.org/ what was that? NOH? I was apparently LLS.org does not go anywhere. We've learned today, ladies and gentlemen.
Yep. We also have volunteers who can sign up for like our donor development colleague was talking to us yesterday. You can sign up just to get mass emails that you literally copy and paste in your own email and you can send to your senators. So like our advocacy part is a really big part of that. You know, if bills, healthcare bills are coming up and things that would negatively affect our patients, volunteering can literally be done from the comfort of your own home. It can be done from your smartphone. Or yeah, like I know we had a woman, shout out to Bev, was in the office this morning doing some letter stuffing, candy stuffing. We're gonna go visit some patients on Valentine's Day. So cool. She was getting all that prepped. And we also have people, like my parents came to one of our walks to help set up our mini bar, and then they left. That was their
mini bar.
So you can really kind of pick how it fits your life, and you can do it from, you know, you can volunteer from wherever with us. Okay. It's a really nice program.
Joe, you got another question over there on that sheet for us?
What's your favorite part about working there?
That's a good question.
So my favorite part is meeting these patients and their families. A really great part about LLS is that every campaign we have has an honored hero. So for example, Man and Woman has a Boy and Girl of the Year, who are Molly and Stanley this year. Molly's a 9-year-old ALL survivor, and Stanley is currently in treatment. He's 3. So just meeting their families and hearing their stories. There are Boys and Girls of the Year from a couple years ago that we still keep in touch with today. So it's really touching just to see these families and see where their stories go and know that hopefully they ended on a good note.
Yeah, I just love, I mean, my job is pretty unique, working with kids who you're motivating them to fundraise, and a kindergartner doesn't know what fundraising is. Mm-hmm. So I always have, you know, these great assemblies where kids come up to me at the end and they're literally digging their milk money out of their pockets and saying, here, you take it. Or I've done assemblies at patient schools, and I just had a patient's mom text me the other day and say he came home from school in tears because kids have been so nice to him since the assembly and just like understanding his disease. So it's a really unique opportunity for me, being, you know, relatively young in my career too, and just kind of learning and seeing how quick kids don't question, you know, they're not selfish at all when it comes to that. They would just give and give and give without fully understanding how big of an impact they're making. And I think that's a really cool feeling to have at the end of every workday.
Okay. So that brings up and what I think is actually a key point. You know, in today's society, we have a lot of people who are just me, not you. So part of why we wanted to do Volunteer Week was because we want to give back to the organizations that we know need help. And we thought of you guys, so I'm glad you guys came in today. So enough, I'll get off my soapbox now. So Joe, got one more question? And then we're going to take a commercial break
How often can someone volunteer?
You can volunteer as much as you want, and we would love it. So, like, we gave a shout-out to Bev earlier. She's in every other week or every week and helps us in the office. Okay. We have all those campaigns I talked about, so you can come and help at all of them. We have a young professionals board that just started last year, so you can come and get involved with that. Mm-hmm. There is many different ways, and we're a very fun group at our office, so you want to come hang out with us.
So, again, we are with the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society of Northern Ohio, livestream.com/LakeEffect. You're also tuned in on lakeeffectradio.org/studio. First and second floor breakers as well. If you have a question, go to livestream.com/LakeEffect and put it in our chat box. So we were actually going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back here, livestream.com/LakeEffect.
40-940-666-666-666-666-15 to request songs.
Here's some simple math that'll make you feel like a genius. Transfer your current car loan to Cardinal Community Credit Union and save serious money. In fact, if you don't save with Cardinal, we'll pay you $50. You save, or we pay. It's a no-brainer. Plus, when you move the loan to Cardinal, we'll reward your brilliance with $125 in cash. Stop in or visit cardinalcu.com. You save, or we pay. Only at Cardinal Community Credit Union.
Offer and rate may vary depending on individual credit history. All loans subject to credit approval. Offer may be withdrawn at any time.
Hey, this is Dan Lasura, a.k.a. DJ Yoshi Blade. You're listening to Lake Effect Radio here at Lakeland. Right now, you.
Okay, so the cart computer decides to be a little goofy on me all of a sudden today. So sorry about that 2 seconds of dinner that we have. Joe, do you have another question to ask them?
Oh, man.
Joe is the man today. He has all of our questions pretty much on that sheet.
Yeah.
So unless you want me to pick one.
No, how does someone get involved?
We're actually going to ask that one.
You ask questions.
So we went over that. So what are your annual needs? Do you guys have any sort of annual needs?
Kind of bringing it back to volunteers. So LLS is a volunteer-based organization. So every campaign that we have has a committee full of volunteers. They work to make the events as best as possible with our staff members. So that is our biggest need. Volunteers are huge. They help us pull off everything we do, and they help us bring in those big dollars that we need to give to our patients.
There was another question I was going to ask that we had on this sheet. Give me 1 second. You guys, I don't know if we went over this, but you guys have any events coming up like in the next month or so?
We do.
Let's talk about that for a little bit.
You know the more specific dates.
I do, yes. So the first event we have coming up is the Students of the Year Grand Finale Gala,
Okay. Which
is Friday, March 9th at the Renaissance Cleveland Hotel. And that's what I talked about before with students in high school fundraising for a scholarship. So that's going to be a really nice night. Anyone's welcome to come and enjoy the event. Then our next event coming up is our Man and Woman of the Year Grand Finale Gala that is also at the Renaissance Hotel on Friday, May 4th. So anyone can come to these. There's going to be silent auctions at both. It's a really nice night. You'll meet the honored heroes that we have. So it's very fun.
Is there a fee to attend the events?
Yes. Students of the Year is $40,
okay.
And Man and Woman of the Year is $150.
Okay.
It's a more formal Grand Finale Gala.
Yep. How many people usually go out to those?
For Man and Woman, we've had around 550 to 600 guests the last couple of years.
Wow.
And then Students of the Year, I'm not sure on the exact number, was around 150 to 200, I think, last year. But we've been growing. So the first year we had it, there were 3 candidates. The second year, there were 8. And this year, there are 15 teams. So
Okay. You
can run solo or you can run with a couple friends. So it should be a pretty full house this year, and we're really excited about it.
That sounds cool.
So one of the other questions I had, and I've actually just lost it. You guys are going to learn as we go through the context of this interview that I always have questions and then they escape my mind because I'm working on getting the cart computer set up. I'm working on a bunch of other things. So what brought you, and this is actually what I wanted to ask. Here, Joe, you can have that back. What brought you to the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society in Northern Ohio? Why did you decide to work there instead of a Big Brothers Big Sisters or Aunt Lakeland or somewhere like that?
So for me, when my grandpa passed away, it just all honestly happened so suddenly that we didn't really honestly have an understanding of what blood cancers was. I mean, with his age and how quickly he progressed through treatment or his lack of treatment. Once he passed away, I felt like I honestly just kind of found the job posting and realized this was a really nice way for me to pay tribute to something that I wanted to understand more and something that had a really large impact on my family. I lost my final grandparent to this, and it's been nice, you know, being able to talk to families and, like, I understand what they're going through. I get it. It's also really nice to work for an organization where I know that we are true to what we say we do. I mean, 77 cents of every dollar that someone donates goes right back to our mission. And for a nonprofit, that's extremely high. I mean, I even see in the office, like, the cost-cutting measures that we take to make sure that any penny that can get in the hands of our patients can. And I don't have to ever question what's going on at LS. I know that when we say these are our mission and this is our values, that we stand true to that. And I think it's a really cool feeling to have in a workplace.
And you actually answered one of the questions I was going to ask later. Is I've seen some memes and stuff out there that say, don't give to these organizations. All this big fat check goes to the CEO of, like, Goodwill is one of them that comes to mind. But it's good to know that 77 cents of every dollar goes right back to the mission. So That eliminates one question for later, but we'll get to that.
If you want to see proof of that our money goes straight to our patients, please come to one of our young professional meetings, because every time without fail we have some hiccup with our technology, and so we always joke, like, see, we didn't spend money on the technology or marketing, so it's pretty funny.
Is it bad for me to mention that I'm actually one of the classroom techs for Lakeland?
Hey, plug yourself when you can. Get the price of brand.
No, I actually enjoy a lot doing classroom tech. That's not when I'm here. So what brought you, Caitlin?
Yeah.
I got it. Okay. What brought you to the LLS NO?
So I have a large family history of cancer. I have an uncle who's a Hodgkin's lymphoma survivor. I have an aunt who's currently in treatment for leukemia. I've had a couple aunts with ovarian, a couple aunts with breast cancer, an uncle with throat cancer. Just the list is on and on. So one day I decided I want to work for a nonprofit. So I started kind of looking through those that I had been touched by. And that's how I found LLS. And LLS, a lot of the research done that's funded by LLS goes and helps advancements in other cancers just because blood is everywhere in the body. Mm-hmm. So it's really nice knowing, too, that while, yes, I'm helping blood cancers, I'm helping what my aunts and other uncles went through. So
I'm going to change gears on you guys for just a little bit. Since we're talking about leukemia and lymphoma, I want to talk about the warning signs, potential warning signs that you have lymphoma, that you have leukemia, that you have whatever, one of the other 127, that was the number, right?
129
of the different blood cancers. What are some warning signs to look for with that?
It depends on the type, just like anything else. Mm-hmm. I know because your white blood cells are rapidly multiplying, and your red blood cells can't carry oxygen as freely as they could prior to that multiplication. Sometimes it is as simple as you feel a lot of fatigue. You feel like your body can't breathe in a certain regard. Like with my grandpa, one of the first signs was he kept saying like he felt like his hands couldn't breathe. Like he was really saying, I feel like my skin can't breathe. And we were like, all right, like tone it down over there. But it was really because oxygen wasn't flowing in his knuckles. So he felt very lethargic, like he's moving slowly. It can appear in the form of a tumor. So like my campaign manager, her lymph nodes were swollen. And so she felt a lump on her neck. So it can present just like you would find a bump anywhere else. Confusion is a big one because, you know, when your blood's not circulating correctly, like getting overly lightheaded, and again, not to cause panic, like I see kids' faces in schools and I say this and they're like, I have a bump on my arm right now, do I have, like, obviously, like any other disease, just because you get lightheaded once, you get confused once, does not mean you have a blood cancer. But with, like, I know with my grandpa, as a, you know, the token patient that I look at, it was like his blood flow was genuinely cut off and he had a lot of confusion and lightheadedness. With my campaign manager, it was swollen lymph nodes, which are really big, like swollen lymph nodes in the neck area, I know are big.
We've had patients or seen patients whose foot hurt and that led them to the doctor. But it is a lot of weird flu-like symptoms, or someone was jaundiced and that's how they kind of found it. So it's really just patient by patient to what you experience that leads to them finding it.
Yeah, I had a patient from Youngstown, and he actually fell down the stairs at a young age and then couldn't walk for quite a few months. And they figured it's because he was so traumatized from falling down the stairs. And then they realize after doctor, because he couldn't talk for himself, he was so young. So after multiple doctor's visits, they realize his legs were actually so compounded with white blood cells that he couldn't move his joints to walk. And so that's something like way off, you know, while you would never guess that that would be a cancer diagnosis, but that was actually how it presented in him. So it is very much patient by patient.
Yeah. Okay. So what we're coming to the conclusion is it's a patient by patient thing. They won't be the same thing for every person. And for those of you hypochondriacs out there, just because you have one little bump or you're confused once doesn't mean you have a blood cancer.
Right, which I feel that I'm 100% a hypochondriac. But don't worry. I mean, I see kids' eyes get big as quarters when I say, like, the word tumor, and they're like, I have this bump or lump. Doesn't mean you have blood cancer, but, I mean, blood tests are common enough when you go in for illnesses that I feel like that's why doctors, you know, that's why they keep your blood so in tune. They want to make sure all those counts stay right all throughout your life.
Definitely.
So if you have one, get it checked out. Definitely.
I put a caveat on that. If you have one and it lingers, definitely get it checked out. True.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, if you, like, one of my things is if I get sick and it lasts almost a week, that's when I go to the doctor. Okay, it's time.
Yeah.
You know, if you have a bump that lasts maybe a couple of weeks, that's when you go get checked out.
Yeah. I would say listen to your body. Like, that's what we hear from patients all the time. It's like, actually, now that we think about this, we found this lump 2 months ago but didn't think about it. Or, like, we were feeling tired for a few weeks. So it's just knowing your own body, knowing what's for any illness, not right. just looking at the phone, what's normal for you and what's not. Because that is, I would say, what I hear a lot in the younger mm-hmm. patients. Like, we actually kind of saw this bruise or this lump or this bump, but like, we let it wait. And then looking back, we realized weeks ago we could have gone to the doctor. So just knowing what's normal for you and right. when something really feels that off kilter that you should go in somewhere.
So, Joey, you got another question on that sheet over there?
Is there any specifications that you need to volunteer? Or?
There is not. As we kind of touched on earlier, if something is not your forte, then we can find another section for you to volunteer. People that aren't very good with technology, we ask to help us stuff letters and fill candy baskets, and they come and hang out at our office. If there's any burly men out there that really just want to lift a whole bunch of things for us, we can always use it on our walks. So, yes, anything that you can do, we will match you to a volunteer opportunity.
So, I guess we should ask what sort of technology needs they have because I'm very good with data entry myself. But
we have, and I cannot think of his name right now. We have a volunteer who comes in.
Greg?
Yes. Who he does data entry for us, because we also have an information resource center. So when patients reach out, whether they reach out to our office or, the chapter in Columbus, Cincinnati, all their data gets put into our system. So mm-hmm. we keep track of why they reach out, how they reach out, whatever. So we do have like someone who comes in specifically does that. He puts together the welcome packets for those patients, make sure they get those welcome packets in a certain amount of time, make sure that our information resource center touches base with them. So we do have, needs like that. We have basic, I feel like basic technology is even just like helping us. Like, we had a girl come in at the beginning of the year who helped me create email templates, PowerPoint templates, so when I got in busy season, I could just have templates to send out. So, yeah. Things honestly as simple as that and as complex as like filling out a whole data system.
Yeah, we also have no real marketing budget, so we're always looking for graphic designers who are interested in designing some flyers for us, or videographers who are looking to make some or will donate their services to make videos, or photographers, anything like that. So
I know some photographers and videographers.
So yeah, video and photo for events is huge. Caitlin's a video gal herself, so commonly she's running around with the camera. we love, we had people that took beautiful, beautiful pictures at our Light the Night events. Some of them were, siblings of our coworkers. Some of them were just volunteers who had a camera and, sent us their pictures later. But it is really cool when we're all running around with our heads chopped off, at these events, to see what other people capture and to kind of step outside the moment and see that. So, yeah, that's video and photo, I feel like, is really big for any of our events and campaigns.
So let's go back and talk about the Light the Night event. How big, I'm trying to figure out how I want to phrase this. Okay, I'll ask it the way I was thinking about asking it. How big is the event? How many volunteers do you guys need for just that event?
For that event, a lot of volunteers. There's probably 50 at least each day. We set up Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So Friday is unloading trucks and getting everything where it needs to go. Saturday is more of setting up each individual tent. And then Sunday is finishing touches, and cleanup is a huge thing for Sunday night. But we see about 10,000 people attend that event.
Oh, wow.
So we need a bunch of volunteers to make that happen.
And there are three of those walks. So there's one in Cleveland that takes part at Wade Oval. There's one in Akron, and then one in Toledo. So each one of those needs, a massive amount. We had in Akron, we had some University of Akron, fraternity members and stuff come out and get their volunteer hours because we needed big, burly men to help us lift things. in Cleveland, I said, my parents really came, helped set up the bar and left. We were all running around doing cleanups, spouses, boyfriends, girlfriends, whoever came just to help at that point, because it gets crunch time and all of a sudden 10,000 people are walking in the gates and we need to be set up and ready to go. So
is the main event just one day, or is it run that entire weekend?
It's just Sunday night.
Sunday night, okay. Yep.
So we see the 10,000 biggest people at the Cleveland Walk, but Akron and Toledo are a nice chunk of people as well. So always looking for volunteers for that.
Do we have a date for that this year?
Yes. So Akron's is October.
They just released them. I'm thinking about all the Facebook events.
It's the first Sunday of October, and then Cleveland is Sunday, October 7th, and then Toledo is at the end of the month. I want to say the 20-something.
I'm mean because we actually help with the event over here. Usually it's the second Sunday for us, too. So
you want to come to ours. I know you do.
I'm the MC for the event that's here in October, so yeah.
Ours is a night event. You can do both.
Let me check the schedule. So you're October 7th, right?
Yes.
That's
Sunday. Okay, so, yeah. Cleveland is Sunday, October 7th, 5 to 9 p.m.
5 to 9 p.m. That's good to know as well. Okay. So if I can get the car computer to work for me here, we're going to take another quick break. Listening to the Do you have a show name, Joe?
No, I don't.
You don't?
I just
okay.
play music. Honestly, I don't know anything about leukemia.
That's
why.
Well, that's not about leukemia. It's about just your show name. But it's definitely about leukemia with them here, though. It's definitely about getting the help that people need to survive these diseases. Not just leukemia and lymphoma, but any sort of blood cancer. Any cancer at all, when we come to think of it. So we'll call today's show the Afternoon Mayhem Radio Show, just for fun. We'll be right back in about 4 minutes. Livestream.com/LakeEffect, LakeEffectRadio.org/studio.
Lakeland's men's basketball as they face Sinclair Community College on Saturday, March 3rd at 3 p.m. For more information about Lakeland Athletics, please visit athletics.lakelandcc.edu. Local music spotlight here on Lake Effect Radio. Taylor Lamborn, In the Wake.
Wake of this tragedy. Calling doctors and deity. Everyone knows I'm praying for you. I just don't know what I'm praying to. Question that you'd go, but I'm not sure that it's their end. You can't leave me till I know. In the wake of this tragedy, call on doctors and those stars, pinholes in to.
Textbooks on reserve at Lakeland Library. Select textbooks are not available for students to check out and use in the library. Donations of current textbooks to the textbook on reserve. Programs are encouraged from instructors and students. If your textbook is not currently available in the library, please contact your instructor to provide a copy of their textbook for the textbook on reserve program. For more information on the library-initiated textbook on reserve program, please call 440-525-74.
Here at Lex, we focus solely on hookah. We have an extremely knowledgeable staff, and we always try to make all of our customers feel at home. This is where true hookah enthusiasts come to smoke. Our prices are reasonable, and our service is outstanding. We are a hookah lounge in the purest sense of the word. A hookah lounge designed and staffed by hookah fans for hookah fanatics. To top it off, we always go above and beyond. We are meticulous in everything that we do. We make sure that your hookah experience is of the highest possible quality. If it doesn't taste right to us, then we won't serve it to you. Majority of our customers turn into regulars and eventually friends because we pride ourselves on our product and service. It's just that simple. We want you to enjoy yourself and expect you to leave happy. If you want the best hookah experience, you come to Lux, located at 37939 Vine Street, Willowby. We invite you to come experience the flavor and see what you've been missing. We hope to see you soon.
Call or text in to 440-940-6615 to request songs.
Welcome back to the Afternoon Mayhem Radio Show here on livestream.com/lakeeffectlakeeffectradio.org/studio. Sometimes I need to breathe, Joe.
Yeah, I see that.
We're talking too fast, Caitlin.
I always talk too fast.
Somehow it's all Joe's fault. But anyway, so let's talk a little bit about the long-term strategy for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know that our hopeful goal will be to completely eliminate blood cancers. Mm-hmm. But do we have any other goals in mind?
Yeah, so we have a couple research projects that are going on currently. Over the past 68 years, LLS has invested more than $1 billion into research advancements. Mm-hmm. And in the upcoming year, we've pledged $48 million to new research.
Nice.
So currently we're working on our BEAT AML trial, which AML stands for Acute Myeloid Leukemia. So in the last 40 years, we have not seen any advancements in AML treatment. Mm. And just in 2017 alone, there were 4 new FDA-approved drugs that came out. And then overall blood cancer treatments, there were 12 FDA-approved drugs in 2017. 10 were partially or fully funded by the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. Cool. So going back to our AML trial, though, it's really cool because they're trying to expand to 20 research sites to find new drugs to help advancements in this type of leukemia. Mm-hmm. One of the first two sites was Ohio State. So it's nice that we are seeing this impact locally in Northern Ohio, and then we're also seeing new advancements in Ohio in general. So it's very cool to be a part of that.
Cool.
Do you want to talk a little bit about CAR T? We also have some different advancements in our CAR T cell mm-hmm. therapies. So just a whole lot going on. Yeah. That therapy is you're kind of taking out the parts of your body that are fighting each other mm-hmm. and essentially like cleaning them to put them back into the body so that they're not fighting it off. They're fighting off the bad things, not fighting the body itself. So there are a lot of good things that are going on with LLS, and cool. we are working to get some more cures.
And I hear there's a free... I shouldn't say that word. I hear there's something food-related that we wanted to talk about before we start yes. wrapping up today.
Yeah, the really easy way, if you're listening to this and you're like, I want to get involved but don't know how, super easy way you can get involved just by eating dinner on Thursday, dinner or lunch, and breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Let's just go Chipotle all day is what I'm going to plug. Because if you go to any Ohio Chipotle on Thursday, February 15th, so the day after Valentine's Day, skip out on that fancy dinner and go to Chipotle instead. And as long as you tell them, I'm here for LLS. If you do go on our Facebook page, so the Northern Ohio LLS Facebook page, we have an event where you can screenshot our flyer as well, but even if you tell them I'm here for LLS, 50% of your meal will get donated right back to our chapter. So that's a super easy way for anybody to take the first step in taking down blood cancers and join us in fighting our mission.
And that's this Thursday.
This Thursday. At any Ohio Chipotle.
Do you have any last minute questions you want to add there, Joe?
No, I mean, I ran out of stuff to say.
That's all right. Do you guys have anything you guys want to add before we start wrapping up?
I would just say we, you know, we take people as they come to us. You know, mm-hmm. anything you can offer, we take it. We work with really great organizations. You know, in Cleveland, we work with like Cleveland Clinic and Key Bank. We work with yachting clubs. I work with school coordinators. So we have people that come from all different walks of life and mm-hmm. volunteer anything to us. You don't have to come to us if you can, you know, only write a $1,000 check or something like that. Right. You can come to us and genuinely volunteer your time to help us get our mailings out and things like that. So any connections you have, we can definitely put to use and make sure that it all works towards the same thing, which is finding cures for those blood cancers.
So for those of you who are interested in learning how to volunteer, you go to lls.org/Northern Ohio, not lls.org, lls.org.
And look out for some intern opportunities. They're normally in the summer and fall to help with the regatta and the Light the Night Walk. So that will be also posted on that same address if you just go to the career tab.
All right. We appreciate you guys coming out today.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
So this is your first time coming here. Hopefully this isn't the last time coming here for you guys.
Yes, hopefully
so
not.
We will see all... I'm going to plug my show real quick. We'll see all you guys Thursday morning at 11 for the Morning Mayhem radio show.
Where after you stop at Chipotle, right?
Well, Chipotle doesn't open till 11 around here, I'm pretty sure. So
Chipotle after the radio show.
That would be after the show, not before, because I don't think the Hospice of the Western Reserve would be very happy if I was late for my interview on Thursday.
True.
So, all right, thank you guys again for coming out, and we will see you guys on Thursday.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you.